Are we still here? Okay, guys, hello and welcome back to Let's Play Terraria 1.3 Blind. I first want to start off by apologizing for last night's session. I know I was really, really quiet throughout it and didn't talk much, but that was because it was late, and I could not wait to continue playing Terraria. However, that's not the only thing. I like how the mechanic and the merchant just switched rooms and sat down in each other's chairs. But that's not the only thing. I would have kept playing last night, but again, the game crashed when I was in the underworld. I believe I'm going to upload that, like, 2-minute video of where it crashed, and I think I discovered the problem of why I keep crashing, because I have two other people on my friends list who are playing the game. I mean, I have loads of people playing the game, but two of them I'm talking to. And both of them have reported that they haven't had any crashes yet. So I was like, what? So I believe I discovered what the crashes are caused from. Every time it crashes, there's only, like, anywhere from 5 seconds to, like, a minute and 30 seconds of video, sometimes a little bit longer, that are recorded before it crashes. Why? Because it's when Bandicam switches to recording another video, because I have Bandicam set to continue recording 20 minutes per video and then cut and start recording a different video. I think what's happening is when Bandicam stops recording and then instantly starts recording again, I don't know, it does something to the game. And then the game's like, I can't keep up. But it doesn't happen every 20 minutes, that's the thing. See, I just got in before, and I got in, pressed record, started walking, and boom, it crashed. Just like I had said has happened before in my past videos. So, I believe it's Bandicam that's causing it. How? I don't really know. It's never done that before. I've recorded loads of Terraria in the past. However, it's got to be something to do with this update, though. However, there are a few fixes I can go through. I mean, because it's very, very painful when I have to keep restarting, and then when I don't have, like, all the shit I collected. I mean, if you look at my inventory, I still have the 2 fire blossoms and all the other stuff, so I really didn't lose anything from being down in the underworld. But sometimes I do lose out, and some of the progress I made isn't there. I haven't checked yet, but let's check. Is all that progress there still? Oops. Yeah, see, That progress is all still there. When I mined out the hellstone and stuff, it's all in my inventory right here, 49 hellstone. So, you know, I don't need to worry about it this time, but there is some solutions that I can go through. A, I can either just keep doing it and deal with the crashings and possibly losing some of my progress and redoing that progress, or I can B, start recording longer videos, aka anywhere between 40 minutes to an hour, maybe even over that, and then that would be the episode. However, right now the file sizes I don't need to render the videos right now, because the file sizes they're fine. The 20 minute videos, the file sizes are anywhere from 200 megabytes up to 500 megabytes, sometimes just a little bit more than that. They're not too big for me to handle, but stretching them up to 40 minutes to 1 hour long, they are going to become big, and I will then need to render them, and sometimes rendering can be weird with 2D games of mine, and then they can make the quality poopy, which I don't want, so I don't think I want to do the rendering thing. So I think I'm just going to, for now, just have to stick with it, and every time it splits the video, that's why every time I always like freeze and stop moving when the video cuts, because I'm waiting for it to crash, sort of thing. So without further ado, though, it is 5-something p.m. where I am, so I've got plenty of time to continue playing this game. And, let's just get to it. One of the things that we did last time was we got the, where's the goblin at? Oh, let me guess, he didn't move in here, did he? No, he didn't. Where are you, goblin? There is no goblin on here. What? There's not even a goblin on the map. What? Oh. Balls. You're kidding me, right? We have to find him again? Oh, that really bones. Okay, well, fine. For now, then, we'll have to go back down and find him at another point. I guess even though we found him way before the crash ever happened, and I still have all my progress from after the crash happened, apparently he didn't save. Or something. Or maybe it was because he died, he never really moved in. I don't really know. Anyways, we can make an obsidian skin potion now. And I can make two of those, and I will make two of those. And let's go back down. I know my inventory's, like, you know, full right now. In fact, you know, we might as well just do what I can here and just zip away some of that stuff. These rocket boots in here. Oh, that's a those are guarding rocket boots. I'm going to take these off temporarily and put these rocket boots on. Put these hellfire arrows in here. Those hellfire arrows are nice. They do a lot of damage and they explode on impact. On impact. Okay, let's go. Now, I did write down a few goals that I wanted to try and go through today. And they include... Well, hold on to me. I mean, there's quite a few goals here, and I doubt we'll get through them all today. But I do want to try and work on them. Why do I always hit 4 to get on my mount? They include things like collecting healthstone for armor, weapons, and tools. I do want to see what the stats for molten armor is. And I also would like to get a few tools. I mean, there is an achievement for getting the pickaxe, of course, and some of the tools you need before you can really move into getting too far in hard mode. Like, you need the molten pickaxe to mine the new ores. I know that much about hard mode. And I also would like some of the tools. Well, that's the tools. I'm sorry, the weapons. I need the fiery greatsword so that I can make the knight's edge before we move into hard mode. Because the knight's edge, like I said, is as far as my knowledge stretches, I believe the Knight's Edge is the best weapon pre-hard mode, or best sword. I'm not going to say best weapon, but it's the best sword. And especially when you get, like, buffs on it, I think one of my games a long time... Uh-oh. I didn't even see where she was. Oh, she's down there. Yeah, balls to you. I think one of the, worlds I played on before, well, I say worlds, was I got a Knight's Edge for somebody I was playing with and for me, and I think the basic damage is like 40-something, but mine did like 57 damage or some crap, because it was like a legendary Knight's Edge, so it just. Oh no. Ostrich spiders. See, we played for quite a while last night before it actually crashed, so I was expecting it to not crash anymore. But no, then it finally did right when I was doing the most important thing. Anyways, so that's one... Oh no, not another Medusa's. Shit. So, there we go. Anyways, so the next one on there is to build a magic mushroom biome above ground. Now, there's a couple reasons why I want to do this. The main reason is because it's going to allow us to build a house in the mushroom biome so that when hard mode comes around, we can have a new NPC move in. I believe he's called the Truffle or something like that. I don't think I've ever had him move in before, but I have built a house in a magic mushroom biome that I built on top. It's really easy. All you need is the seeds, and then you've got to put down a whole bunch of mud above ground, and that's pretty much all you do. Also, these are the rocket boots. They're purple because I'm wearing the shadowy armor, so if they're normally just red. They look like flames. And then the next goal on the list is to build a house there to get ready for him to move in whenever we get around to hard mode. The next one on the list is to find